Thank God for allowing us to be in this house one more time.
Amen.
Amen. I'm not going to bore you. I'm just, while you're standing, would you turn with us to a major book that I think all of us are familiar with, the Gospel of St. Luke.
Amen.
Luke 17 chapter. 17 chapter of St. Luke. And we're going to look at verses 26, begin at verse 26, and following on. We have to say amen.
Amen.
17th chapter of St. Luke, begin at verse 26. It reads like this. I'm reading from the King James Version. It says, as it was in the days of Noah, so shall it also be in the days of the Son of Man. They did eat, they drank, they married wives, they were given in marriage, until the day that Noah entered into the ark, and the flood came and destroyed them all. Also, as it was in the days of Lot, they did eat, they drank, they bought, they sold, they planted, they built. But the same day that Lot went out of Sodom, it rained fire and brimstone from heaven and destroyed them all. Even thus shall it be in the day when the Son of Man is revealed. Amen. We're going to stop right there. We want us to think on this subject here for this day, that think on these words here, the second coming of Jesus. The second coming.
Yes, sir.
Not the first, but the second coming.
All right.
I know that we all know that we are Urshas. You may be seated. You thank God again for you, Zion. You thank God again for you, Brother Holmes, and for allowing us the opportunity to stand in on behind God's sacred desk to declare God's word.
Yes.
Not my word, but God's word.
Amen.
I just believe that whatever the word of God says, it will come to pass.
All right.
I don't know about you, but it's going to come to pass. Whether we are here or not.
Amen.
I'm going to first start off by saying that time. I think we've all used that term. Time. We know that time waits on nobody.
All right.
And I don't know about you, but I believe that we have all said somewhere in our life that where has the time gone? I was just thinking on my granddaughter, my latest granddaughter, about this time last November. November 17 to be exact.
Yes, sir.
I did the same birthday to sister full of ass, I believe.
Yes, sir.
And she's 1 year old now.
Yeah.
And now she's a year old. And walking and talking.
Yes, sir.
Time.
Yeah.
Time.
Time.
It flies, doesn't it?
Yes, sir.
We all can say, where has the time gone?
Amen.
And I don't know about you, but I've learned in this life that time waits for nobody.
Right.
And so there's a time for everything.
Yes.
Under the sun. There's nothing new. under the sun, but the thing about it that I want to make sure that we all take part in is that we all have a limited time on this earth.
Amen.
Am I right about it?
Yes.
But you know, God has unlimited time. But we got limited time. Now, I think we can all believe that. And we this season of Advent where we are right now, we know that we're in the, many of us call this the Thanksgiving season. From Thanksgiving all the way to Christmas time, that we've been taught down through the years that that Jesus was born in this month. Or December 25th, some people we believe that we don't know. But the thing about it that he was born.
Amen.
That's right. That's for sure that he was born.
Yes, sir.
My Bible says and it teaches me that he was born in Bethlehem. I believe Sister Anderson just singing a few, some of y'all heard it or not, but I heard her singing, "Go tell it
on the mountain."
On the mountain.
Yes. Amen.
Everywhere. Go tell it.
Yes.
That Jesus Christ was born.
Amen.
Oh yeah, he was born. And when he was born in the city of Bethlehem, and we've been taught down through the years that he was born in a stable, in a manger.
Yes.
Yeah, he was born. And he came to this world. And yeah, I don't know about you, but he came to this world to save lost souls like us.
Yeah.
I don't know about you, but I've been lost.
Yes, sir. Yes.
I don't know about you, but I haven't always been found.
Yes.
That's what the man, that's what the word says. Amazing grace. Can I take one time?
Yes, sir.
Any time.
How sweet the sound.
Yes, sir.
That's what saved
me. The wretch like me.
A wretch like me.
Yes,
I once
was lost.
I don't know about you, but I once was lost.
Yes, sir.
But right now, I'm back.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Amen.
I ain't been saved all of my life, but I know that y'all would say, I don't know about you, but I've done some things.
Yes, sir.
That I'm ashamed of.
Yes, sir.
We don't want to hold you too long. But we want to fast forward.
All right.
We want to go past. We don't talk too much about the second coming.
Yeah.
Amen.
Of Jesus. He's coming back.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he's coming back. We already know that he had walked the dusty roads of Jerusalem when he was at the age of 12.
Yes.
He went to Jerusalem to worship with his parents.
Yeah.
He went there and he stayed behind. And then on that way back home, he stayed behind. Mm-hmm. 3 days later, they went back.
Yeah.
And he was teaching
the word.
Lawyers and doctors.
Yeah. Yes.
I heard him say, I think you heard him say too, I must be.
Yeah.
Not my father's business.
Not my business, but
my
father's business.
Yeah.
That's what we ought to all be about.
Yeah.
Our father's business.
Yes.
Not your world. I want to make sure that we get this straight. I believe clarity. Not your daddy's business. But my father's business.
Yeah. Yeah.
I'm talking about the creator of the world. I'm talking about his business.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. That is to be a witness.
Witness.
Everywhere we go, we talked about that a little bit in Sunday school this morning.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Peter and John went up there and they didn't even know that lame man. They told him that in the name of Jesus.
Yeah.
There's something about that name.
Yes.
Yeah, there's something about that name.
Right?
In the name of Jesus.
Yeah,
he's the one that made you well.
Yes.
Oh yeah, he put running in your ankles. He strengthened your legs.
Yeah.
Jesus did that. But now we want to just fast forward. your favorite song is, Zion, but there's a song that comes to my mind right now. It says that, were you there?
All right.
When they crucified my Lord?
Yes.
Were you there? Were you there when they put nails in his hand?
Yes.
Were you there?
Yes.
Were you there when they put him in the tomb? All right. And that's the question we all need to ask. Were you there? I wasn't there. But sometimes it causes me to tremble.
Yeah.
All you think about what he went through.
All right.
Just for you and I.
Yes, sir.
Yeah, yeah, okay. We ought to be thankful.
Yes, sir.
He went through all of this for all of us.
Amen.
Yeah, I'm so glad that he did that. But he told his disciples that, you know the story, that he had to go up to Jerusalem and he had to suffer many things. And then on the third day, he would rise again. And he rose, just like he said he would.
Amen.
But in this lesson here today, that he wanted to let you know, he told his disciples, I'm going to go away, but I'm coming back.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, you ought to be glad that he's coming back. I don't know about you. But in this world in which we live, seeing all around us, destruction, everywhere we go, somebody said, everywhere I go, there is trouble.
Right.
Trouble everywhere.
Everywhere.
Where I go. Yeah, there's no safe neighborhood. You can go to Island Boy.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Yes, sir.
It's trouble.
Yes, right.
In Island Boy.
Yes, sir.
Some people say it's trouble inside. That ain't no trouble. It's trouble everywhere.
That's right.
Because the devil is everywhere.
Yeah.
And he's on his job. Busy trying to drag people against the Lord.
Yes.
Oh yeah, he was troubled way back in Noah's day too.
Yes.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
Yeah, you know, said the wickedness had increased in the land.
Yeah.
Way back in Noah's day. Noah, God told Noah to build an ark.
Yeah.
Am I right about it?
Yeah.
He told him that the spirit of man, the spirit of God would not always dwell with man. You think about all, you don't say what the population was way back then, but he told Noah, I'm going to give you 120 years. Ooh, that he's going to destroy man. You think about that. All the people that were on the earth.
Yeah.
What would 8 people say? Noah and his family.
Yeah. All right. Right.
His 3 sons, his wives, and their daughters, their wives. So we see here out of all that population that God saved them. By grace, that's why he says that God said that Noah walked with him.
Yes, sir.
Yes.
And that God saved him.
Yes.
Oh, while people outside laughing with about Noah, here's a man building a big boat on dry land.
Right.
The Bible said it had never rained.
Yes, sir.
Right.
But the Bible said that God's word said that it's going to rain.
Yeah.
It's going to rain, and the Bible teaches me.
Yes, sir.
I don't know what your Bible said, but it said rain 40 days.
40 days.
And
40 nights.
Yeah, it stayed up on the earth for 150 days. Check it out for yourself.
Right.
Yeah, he rained.
Yeah.
And then everybody else was destroyed. But one thing about it, above.